Who controls the shadows, shaping the world from the hidden depths of society? Today, we delve into the clandestine empire of wealth and power, revealing the 10 richest drug dealers who ever lived. Their stories are not just about money, they are tales of ambition, power, and the high price of illicit fortune. As we peel back the layers of these secretive giants, prepare to be astonished by the scale of their operations and the depths of their influence. Make sure to subscribe to our channel, WOW TV, for more eye-opening revelations about the figures who operate from the shadows, shaping history from behind the scenes. Number 10. Al Capone. Net worth, $1.3 billion. Alphonse Gabriel Capone, better known as Scarface, transitioned from a promising student in a Catholic school to the most infamous crime leader of the Prohibition era in the United States. Born in 1899 to Italian immigrants in Brooklyn, New York, Capone's early life was a mix of modest beginnings and early signs of defiance. His expulsion from school at 14 for hitting a teacher marked the start of his descent into the criminal world. Capone's knack for leadership and a keen business sense led him to Chicago, where he joined Johnny Torrio's gang. This move was pivotal, allowing Capone to climb the ranks and eventually head the Chicago outfit. Under his rule, the gang smuggled alcohol, ran illegal breweries, and paid off police and politicians, creating a vast empire during a time when the sale of alcohol was banned. Capone's lifestyle of luxury and power was infamous, showcasing his success in the criminal underworld. However, his empire's foundation on illegal activities led to his downfall. In 1931, he was convicted for tax evasion, serving 7 years in prison. Number 9. Griselda Blanco. Net worth, $2 billion. Griselda Blanco, known as the Black Widow, was a pioneer in the drug trafficking world, setting a precedent for both the wealth and violence associated with the cocaine trade. Born in Cartagena, Colombia, in 1943, Blanco's journey from a life of poverty to becoming one of the most powerful figures in the Medellin cartel is a testament to her ruthless ambition and cunning. Early in her life, Blanco turned to crime, eventually moving to the United States to expand her empire. Her method of smuggling cocaine into the country in the 1970s and 1980s was revolutionary, involving lingerie with secret compartments. Number 8. Carlos Letter. Net worth, $2.7 billion. Carlos Enrique Letter Rivas played a pivotal role in transforming the cocaine trade into a global enterprise. Born in Armenia, Colombia, in 1949 to a German father and a Colombian mother, Letter's early ventures into car theft set the stage for his later ascendance as a drug kingpin. His ambition led him to the Bahamas, where he acquired Norman's Cay in 1978, turning it into a strategic hub for smuggling cocaine into the United States. This island became almost a symbol of Letter's power, serving as a fortress from which he could operate with impunity and flaunt his wealth and influence. Letter was not just a drug trafficker, he was a revolutionary with a cause, aiming to overthrow the Colombian government and eliminate the extradition treaty with the US. However, his very success led to his downfall. The visibility of Norman's Cay drew law enforcement's attention, culminating in his extradition to the United States in 1987. Number 7. The Orejuela Brothers. Net worth, $3 billion. Gilberto and Miguel Orejuela, the masterminds behind the Cali cartel, strategically maneuvered their way into becoming one of the most powerful drug trafficking organizations by prioritizing stealth and corruption over overt violence. This approach set them apart from the infamous Medellin cartel. Operating from Santiago de Cali, a crucial hub for narcotics distribution, they established a vast network that facilitated their control over a significant portion of the cocaine entering the United States. The brothers' innovative methods included embedding cocaine in legal goods and utilizing an extensive network of informants within law enforcement to evade capture. Despite their efforts to maintain a low profile, their empire's expansion attracted international attention, leading to their arrest and extradition to the United States. Number 6. Jose Gonzalo Rodriguez Gacha. Net worth, $5 billion. Jose Gonzalo Rodriguez Gacha, also known as El Mexicano, was a pivotal figure in the Medellin cartel, illustrating the lethal overlap of drug trafficking and paramilitary forces in Colombia. His dominion over extensive rural areas allowed him to not only control the production and distribution of cocaine, but also to wield significant influence over local communities. Gantz's investment in land and legitimate businesses served as a front for his illicit activities, further embedding the cartel's reach into the fabric of Colombian society. His establishment of new trafficking routes, particularly through Mexico, revolutionized the drug trade, increasing the cartel's efficiency and profitability. Number 5. Kunsa, net worth, $5 billion. Kunsa, known as the Opium King, commanded the drug trade in the Golden Triangle, an area bordering Thailand, Laos, and Myanmar, renowned for its opium production. His dominance over the region's opium and heroin trade from the 1970s through the 1990s showcases his ability to navigate the complex interplay of regional politics, ethnic militias, and international demand for narcotics. By forging alliances with local warlords and corrupt officials, Kunsa effectively created a state within a state, operating with near impunity. His operations funded insurgencies and contributed significantly to the regional instability. Despite numerous attempts by the Thai, Burmese, and American governments to capture him, Kunsa remained elusive, ultimately negotiating a surrender that allowed him to retire without facing extradition or significant legal repercussions. Number 4. The Ocho Brothers, net worth, $6 billion. George, Juan David, and Fabio Ochoa were central figures in the notorious Medellin cartel, illustrating how individuals can transition from a conventional business, such as cattle breeding, to becoming pivotal players in the illegal cocaine trade. Their involvement significantly influenced the cartel's operations, highlighting the blurred lines between legitimate enterprises and criminal activities. The Ochoas adeptly avoided law enforcement capture and resisted extradition to the United States for years, demonstrating the complex interplay between drug traffickers and global legal systems. Their story is reflective of the broader issue of how deeply the drug trade can embed itself within local economies and societies, corrupting structures and evading traditional forms of law enforcement through both violence and strategic alliances. Number 3. Dawood Ibrahim Kaskar, net worth, $6.7 billion. Dawood Ibrahim Kaskar's journey from the streets of Mumbai to becoming a designated global terrorist encapsulates the transformation of organized crime in the age of globalization. As the leader of D Company, a syndicate involved in everything from narcotics to illicit finance and terrorism, Ibrahim's activities have had a significant impact across South Asia and beyond. His ability to operate a complex criminal network demonstrates the modern challenges faced by international law enforcement in tackling such fluid and diversified criminal entities. Dawood's alleged involvement in the 1993 Mumbai bombings and his subsequent evasion of capture underscore the difficulties in apprehending individuals who have the resources to manipulate state borders and legal jurisdictions. Number 2. Amado Carrillo Fuentes, net worth, $25 billion. Amado Carrillo Fuentes, also known as the Lord of the Skies, dramatically altered the landscape of narcotic smuggling with his innovative use of aircraft to transport drugs. This approach not only exemplified the extreme measures drug lords will undertake to safeguard their operations, but also marked a significant evolution in the methods of drug trafficking. Carrillo Fuentes' leadership of the Juarez cartel saw it grow into a dominant force within the narcotics trade, illustrating the deadly ambition that drives such figures. His resort to plastic surgery in an attempt to avoid law enforcement capture, leading to his death, serves as a stark illustration of the paranoia and risks inherent within the drug trade. Number 1. Pablo Escobar, net worth, $30 billion. Pablo Escobar's name is synonymous with the cocaine trade, representing the epitome of a drug lord's rise and fall. His control over the majority of the cocaine shipped to the United States during the 1980s and early 1990s brought him not only unprecedented wealth, but also significant influence within Colombia and beyond. Escobar's strategy of combining outright violence with plata o plomo, silver or lead, effectively terrorized and manipulated politicians, law enforcement, and civilians alike. His death in a police shootout in 1993 marked the culmination of an extensive manhunt, closing the chapter on one of the most infamous criminals in history. However, the legacy of Pablo Escobar extends beyond his death, serving as a potent reminder of the destructive impact of the drug trade on societies, the challenges in combating such deeply entrenched networks, and the ongoing global battle against narcotics trafficking and its associated violence. The stories of these individuals are not just tales of wealth and power, they are stark reminders of the drug trade's human cost. Our journey through the world of the richest drug dealers in history challenges us to reflect on the complex issues surrounding drug trafficking and the global efforts required to combat it. Subscribe to our channel for more insights into the darker corners of history and the ongoing fight for a safer world.